Okay everyone, sorry, my video just cut off, my battery's going to die, so it's charging at the moment. So this is part two of cooking with me. So all of it now is brown and everything, looks delicious. So now I'm going to add in the chopped tomatoes. This is bubbling very well. Just like the way I like it, so I'm just bringing it down to 6, like so. Okay, so I'm just gonna add some chopped potatoes or tomato puree. So I put on my last video, so I just did all steps there, what you need to get. So this is the tomato puree. So I already put the chopped tomatoes in. So this is just a bit of flavoring. Hopefully I can do it just one hand. I probably can't do it one-handed. Maybe I can. Maybe I will. Oh, I can do a little bit though. One-handed is such a skill. I don't know if I can get any more out of that. So you just mix it around as you do. So if you have any salt, I actually forgot to put down that. So you put some salt in. And then you put some herbs in. So you put some of this herb in. Just a little small bit though, it's not too much. You don't want to burn. A little small bit, there you go. And if it's getting sticking at the bottom, which hopefully now it's not because I put a lot of this thing in, so I like. But if it does stick, you can put some water in and it'll just unstick it in the bottom. And I'm just checking here. So because I'm allergic to onions and garlic, I don't put it in, but if you can eat onions and garlic, more than welcome, put it in, just to Same way, you cook the onion, or cook the onion. You chopped up the onion, chopped up the garlic and whatnot, and you pop it in. I just don't put onions in. It's just because I'm allergic to them, and garlic I'm allergic to, so I just cook it like this. So this is going to be ready in a while. The pasta would be taking 8-10 minutes. I'll probably have some, but then I have to take a tablet because of my allergies. I'll probably just have that. So there you go, it's going to cook away. And yeah. I actually made tea and I got distracted, so I'm not eating it. Or not eating it, not drinking it. So I got this for lunch for tomorrow and work. It looks nice actually. Don't know how many sins in this, but like anyway. It looks nice. It looks like just tuna and pasta really. With mayonnaise and tuna and pasta. Does look nice. And then I'm just going to get my gluten-free bread. And like I can cut it up and put it in a roll or something, like, you know. So, that's my lunch tomorrow. Best option. So, still cooking away. I think this is looking good now. Cooking. So next you do, you get the plates. We use this, these plates are amazing. I always want to put some courgettes in them. Might make courgettes. Watch this, everyone. What I'm gonna do. Bless everyone, as you do. One is such an amazing thing. I must say, this is such an amazing thing. So, I'll show you all about this one. So amazing. This is so amazing. So, you get your projects. And then just cut the top off. And then you get all this. That was over here. Okay, never mind. Ignore that. And then you just. I'll do this here to show you. You just put this in here. Okay, I don't think this will show you, but hold on. There you go. What's going on? I actually might have this for my pasta. Thank you. Okay. It's just like spaghetti bolognese sort of thing. This is much better. That's so funny. Anyway, there you go. So, that is how to do the courgette. So there you go. So I'm just going to put it into the pan. Delicious, so put that all the way over there. It's done. It's done. So now I'm just waiting for this to cook.